Welcome back to Winging It Buffalo Style. It is another Tuesday in our hot sauce where we're joined by local radio personality Judd from Kiss 98.5, where we look at all of the new music and trending news in music. So let's start with someone who's making a pretty big comeback this year.
Yeah.
This, is, of course, is Eminem. He's coming back with the Marshall Mathers LP2. Big news here is all of the amazing collaborations.
Yeah, it's a great album, just came out. It's very much like the first Marshall Mathers LP. Back to that not so much kind of like joking style that he had the last one where he made fun of a lot of people, into the Eminem, the Detroit City Boy that everybody came to love. And yeah, a lot of really cool collaborations. Fun thing is the video game you're gonna be playing later, you're definitely gonna recognize a song, Survival, which is on the album, because that was all in the commercials for the Call of Duty game that you're gonna be playing. Some of the cool collaborations, track number 7, we can't say the title of the song, but Skylar Grey, she wrote Love the Way You Lie and produced that one for him, so now she's actually on a song with him, wrote this one too. One of the cool ones, The Monster, we're playing it now on Kiss 98.5 featuring Rihanna, great song. The one of the most interesting one is Nate from Fun is on a track, which
I
you would have
him.
Never expected.
Really?
Yeah,
he's
on a thing called Headlight. Headlight is the song, so, track number 12 on the CD, but Nate from Fun, totally not what you would expect on an Eminem song, but he's on there, and Sia too, the girl that sings in Titanium, a couple of other Flo Rida songs, she's on there as well. So a lot of really cool collaborations on this Eminem
now,
album.
Now, of course, Eminem, you know, his lyrics are always a little bit offensive. It's definitely not for the kids out there, but you know, he can be pretty playful and pretty fun. Do you think that we're going to hear a little bit more of that fun Eminem that we first fell in love with?
Yeah, there's some definite fun Eminem. Berserk was one of those fun songs where it was just kind of all over the place. There was so much going on. The Monster, which is this current single with Rihanna, is definitely more of a serious one. But it's not as serious as Love the Way You Lie, because that was a real serious song, but sort of along those lines. The album's really, though, multifaceted, where he's got the very fun songs and the very hip-hop heavy. He's got a couple EDM kind of tracks in there, which is so big right now, and then you're straight ahead, you know, Eminem, Listen to Me Rap.
His angry voice combined with someone's beautiful voice like Ariana or Nate from Fun, it makes sense. It works.
Yeah,
and of course,
it's
the best music to work out to also.
Yeah.
Makes you want to run a little faster.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Fire that up on your turkey trot mix. All right, we have Britney Spears. Where she posted a new song called Perfume on her Facebook page. Not a scent, it's a song. What
yes.
is this one like?
It's a ballad. It's kind of, think like old Britney Spears, Lucky, and all these things like that.
She wrote a ballad called Perfume. That is just so Britney Spears.
Yeah, and it's there's not very many words in the song. She kind of talks about the smell and lots of over and over again. I'm not sold on this Britney
song
yet.
Is she coming out with a new perfume that maybe she's doing this to like...
It's got to be coming down the line. But this is no work, which we all of us really liked.
Well, you know, she's been doing a lot of dance-heavy mix with a lot of auto-tune, not so much singing. When you hear ballad, of course, you think of singing. Is this maybe something that we shouldn't... hearing from Britney Spears at this point in her career?
I mean, she had the British accent sing talk voice down really, really good.
And we loved it. We
songs.
All bought
we
it.
We all loved it. This is a very different. It's definitely. It sounds like old Britney. I don't know how much of it is real old Britney. It is a little different seeing that she is working with Will.i.am throughout the track, so I assume that all of them would going to be this dance one. This one's a little too early to see what this
we'll
is going
to
be.
Hear it for
this will be when she needs a break in her Vegas show to chill out after the dance.
Yeah.
You know, she just needs something that she can.
I think
get
she
through.
Should come out with a remake of Lucky. I think that was
that would have been great.
One of her most popular hits.
All right, one more thing we have to talk about before you go.
Yeah,
is Macklemore. He's coming to Buffalo.
Yeah, going to be here on Saturday, the first Niagara Center. From what I hear, tickets are still available. I know we're giving away some in the afternoon. I have them on Kiss 98.5, but going to be a big show. He's got a lot of songs, which, you know, when it was only a year ago that really Thrift Shop came out was a big deal, and you wouldn't think that somebody like that would be able to go out on a full arena tour, but he's got Thrift Shop under his belt, Can't Hold Us, Same Love, and now he's working on a new single, White Walls. So it's going to be a very good show. He's got Taweeb Khalib, who's opening for him, and a couple of other smaller acts, but it's going to be a good show. Ryan Lewis in town,
Lauren and I have talked about this multiple times. You know, for the people that heard Macklemore on the radio and haven't heard the rest of his album, they might be in for a little bit of a shock.
It's
very different than his Thrift Shop.
Yeah, Thrift Shop was kind of an atypical song from The Heist, which is his album. He is almost like a... little, it's sort of like Eminem in sort of the heavier rap style. He does have his play side in Thrift Shop and Can't Hold Us. But then, yeah, you think of some of the undertones of Same Love that he dives into, gets into some serious stuff. So I'm interested to see what kind of stage show he puts on, because he seems like a very, other than Thrift Shop, kind of plain guy. So I don't you know, see him flying through the arena or lots of fireworks and explosions. So I'm very interested to see what the show's going to be like.
I just want to know how many people are going to come in huge fur coats. So if you want one, you might want to head out to the Goodwill.
If they're smart, they're going to sell them at the gift shop inside of the arena with Macklemore logos on them.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in, Jed. And of course, we'll be back with you next Tuesday to continue talking about all of the news and music. But right now, we're going to head over to our